Let's look at an example of an integral involving the product of tangent and secant that does not fit into the easy rules that we have for their powers. So in this case we have a tangent to an even power and secant to an odd power. So for this example we have the integral of tangent squared x times secant x dx. The process that we're going to follow is to convert the tangent squared x part into secant, and we can do that using the Pythagorean identity, which is tangent squared x plus 1 equal to secant squared x. So that means that tangent squared x is equal to secant squared x minus 1. So going back to our integral, we have the integral of the tangent squared x, which we can rewrite as the integral of secant squared x minus 1. And then that quantity times the original secant x dx. This is then equal to, if we FOIL that out, the secant cubed of x minus the secant x dx. And then we can take those and we can split those across the subtraction. So into two integrals, we have the integral of secant cubed x dx minus the integral of secant x dx. And we already know that the integral of secant x is equal to the natural log of the absolute value of secant x plus tangent x. So all we have to do is figure out the secant cubed part. And so we have a power reduction formula that we can use, and that says that the integral of secant to the nth power of x dx is equal to 1 over n minus 1 times secant to the n minus 2 power x times tangent x plus the fraction n minus 2 over n minus 1 times the integral of secant to the n minus 2 power of x dx. So in this example we have secant cubed of x, which means the n in our formula is equal to 3. So if we follow the formula, the integral of secant cubed x dx will equal 1 over 3 minus 1 times secant to the 3 minus 2 power of x times the tangent of x plus the fraction 3 minus 2 over 3 minus 1 times the integral of secant to the 3 minus 2 power of x dx. And then we have the remaining secant part, so minus the integral of the secant x dx. Let's simplify some of that. This will all equal 1 half the secant x times tangent x plus 1 half times the integral of secant x dx minus our integral of secant x dx. And we can combine these two integrals of secant x. One's a positive half, one is a minus the whole integral. So a positive half and a negative 1 would turn into a minus half. So putting all this together, we have 1 half the secant x tangent x minus 1 half the integral of secant x dx. And then our last step is to do that final integral of secant. So this turns into 1 half secant x tangent x minus 1 half the natural log of the absolute value of secant x plus tangent x. And then plus our constant C.